Sumter Long Cane Ranger District Public Dove Fields, dedicated to Neo Gobbler Costs.
Let's go check it out.
All right, guys, so quick rundown of the place. These are the just different times that it's open. This is a great field, especially to take someone new to dove hunting or new to hunting in general. So I like this place a lot. There's a lot of people here. The camaraderie is good. Everybody's super nice and friendly, and they answer your questions. You can tell there's a lot of people here, but everybody's good old Carolina boys and girls and kids and families. They're just good people out here. So. So you can see that there's people lined all the way down the road. We got us a little spot here. It's a nice little spot. I think the birds are gonna probably fly down here, get shot at a bunch of times, and hopefully swoop to me. First shots. Here they go.
God, there's a bunch of them.
That was cool. Flying on the line.
Crumple.
Yoo-hoo! That was awesome. Hell yeah.
Good shot. Ah! And shoot.
Birds are flying though. This is like a heck of a lot of fun. Like, I'm having a blast. But regardless. So. Heck yeah. I'd highly recommend coming out here. Even though there's a lot of people, don't be deterred. Don't be discouraged, because it's still a whole lot of fun. The camaraderie is awesome. Everybody's been super nice. And if you guys were out here dove hunting today, give us a like, give us a follow, and comment, share. Well, I'm about to be brave right now and put the drone in the air. Please don't shoot it. All right, everyone, so we put the drone up and we came across some birds down here, and about 9 or 10 power poles. This is going to be your hot spot. A lot of times these doves will come out of the woods, and the woods kind of goes jets out, and they like to come out of those little fingers where they're kind of wrapping around. I mean, you can't really pattern doves. Everybody says they do this and they do that, but this, I'll tell you right now, more shots came out of this area than anywhere else. If you get here late, would probably be good to get in the back corner on this side. Nobody really walks there, but I was noticing that the doves circle around and either fly to the corner or right over here, like in the middle of this field in this bottom. So we got a few pieces of dove in here. I did go ahead and get some steak too. Alan's never had dove before.
I have not.
I think it'll be a good comparison. So, but you can see how red the meat is. This is the dove breast. Compared to like a piece of just steak, like flank steak, flattened. So, all right, guys, so we got our dove breasts. I didn't get a whole lot, but we got a few pieces here. And then I got a few pieces of steak to go with it. This skirt steak I'm gonna stuff some peppers with. But I wanted Alan just to try the dove meat for what it was without, you know, it being in anything. He's never had dove before, and it's just super good. All right, so what do you think, Alan? Have you ever had dove before?
This is basically my first time eating dove.
Isn't that like tenderloin? Yeah, that gives you the urge, doesn't it, to go hunting again?
It gives me the urge to do a lot better than what I did. Yeah. I'll tell you that much.
That's pretty good. Well, what'd you think of the dove, Alan? Stupid good.
No, so, it's horrible. Don't eat no dove. It ain't worth it. Don't even try. Don't even go out there. No, I'm serious. There's now. No point. I'm talking to all y'all. Don't even try to go out there.
Terrible.
It's actually probably one of the best things that God ever put on this good green earth.
Maybe next time we'll kill a few more doves and have something a little more exciting to show y'all, but it was just too delicious. We scarfed it down. How many rounds you shoot, Alan?
Oh, I went through 50 and I had the dang greatest time. I was called blind. Are you blind out there? No, it was great.
Like I said earlier, everybody out there is just, it's a fun time. Like, it's everybody out there is having a blast, you know, with their kids and making jokes and stuff if you miss. I mean, it really is. It's a cool place to take your kids, and it's a cool place for if you've never been hunting before. Get all your licenses and go out there and talk to somebody and say at the gate, I've never been hunting before, and watch how many people try and help you. I guarantee you. All right, guys, again, we're out here at the dove field and just cleaning up some trash and some brass. Everybody leaves their crap everywhere on public fields, so it kind of sucks. Ooh, got some high brass out here. Well, that's awesome. We're out here picking up shotgun shells, and we immediately get rewarded from nature with some wild muscadines. There's a bunch out here, and they're still perfect. If you don't know about muscadines, they grow in the south in the hot weather, a lot in South Carolina. You don't see them as much in North Carolina, but you will find them in places wild. They do have a pit inside and a very tough skin. A lot of people swallow the seed like I just did, or you can just get the juice, spit the rest. Whew. Not gonna lie, I got a headache from bending over like 300 times, but I got a good amount of shells. And I think if I get any more, my bag might break. I got about 10-minute walk back, so I'm gonna get some on the way back. There's a bunch of deer tracks in this field too, so I don't know if they let you deer hunt it or not, but we're gonna look into that. Come on, Belle, let's roll. There's some more muscadine. Guys, remember to pick up your stuff if you come out in a public place like this. You can't expect people who come out here and cut the grass and take care of the place to do that too, you know what I mean? I mean, they got a lot of work. You can see this is all planted for us, for our enjoyment, so take care of it, and it might stick around a little bit longer. You never know. All right, guys, so this is a good time just to ask y'all to like and subscribe to my channel. If you like what you see and enjoy hanging out with me, it would help me a lot if you'd subscribe. We've already got about 100 subscribers, and we're trying to hit that 250 mark before the dead of winter, and Josh is gonna get me to jump in some cold water, maybe. We get that 250 mark, so. But anyways, you guys, you're awesome. I appreciate you following me. It's getting me back out here, doing the things that I love, and inspiring me to record it and just go see new places and do new things. So it's an awesome venture for me, so I appreciate it. We'll see you guys soon.